chance here. And that's a well taken goal. And good afternoon and welcome to our football coverage here on CW Sport Radio. Coming to you from a rather overcast looking St Neots. This is how we think the team will line up today for Kevin Hoover's side. Liz Pamplin in goal. Back four of Gemma Moore on the left, Abby Davies on the right, with Albany Hodgson partnering Kaylee Ann Burt, the skipper, in the middle. So Kaylee Ann Burt, who's back last weekend, was away celebrating her birthday in Ireland. Now a late change, and so obviously Katie White comes in on the left wing with Emma Jenkins on the right wing. Central midfield, Gemma Croucher with Charlotte Crisp, with Kelly Blanche Flower up front alongside Vicky Lines. Cambridge United just three on the bench, so with Grace Canfield, 16-year-old, prodigious talent with a lot of potential as a striker. Obviously promoted from a development team today alongside that attacking midfielder Chloe Smith and Gemma Newell. Squad information we've been given, I think it's just numbers put on the team sheet, so in no sort of discernible order. So apologies that some managers do sort of put formations out, so we're sort of guessing as we go. Immediately, dangerous Sophie Vale on this left flank, with a little ball up onto the edge of the penalty area, picked up by the skipper Morgan, who so danger there, Russian brought down within the first minute or so, and this could be not the start that Cambridge want. Danica Dougal is stepping up to take this spot kick, so it's Dougal versus Pamplin. Dougal wins a run up, sends keep the wrong way straight. Well, as I say, Pamplin dives to the right hand side, the ball goes fairly straight, and Cambridge already 1-0 down with barely 90 seconds on the clock. There's me Lancaster going wide on the right, but it's again the ball played all the way back to the heart of the visitors' defence, brought out again by Courtney Lumley, dispossessed, and Blanche Flower, and Lumley's lunged in there and sold herself, and here comes Blanche Flower on the right hand side, plays the ball into the box just across the face of goal there, and just a little too far there for Vicky Lines to get to. Lines making her debut, obviously on a dual registration this season, but has played a couple of times for St Ives this season. But on a dual registration, so again, a ball into the box there, and Amy Mullet gathers it under a bit of pressure there as Lines. Van Morgan has actually gone into the penalty area, so it's actually Therese Addison who's going to take this. It's played at two central and picked up safely by Liz Pamplin, the keeper. Ball in her hands and looking to launch this high as a weather. The sort of dip, and Katie White is there today. One of the former faces of Cambridge United who's at the back this season after a breakaway as a ball into the box. And the shot on the turn there, and also shot at first time off, connected by Russian, but intercepted and slapped behind by Jenkins. Makes her first call up this season. An interesting ball across the box, and that out to the left hand side for Billericay, picked up by Lucy Jones, and immediately pumps across back into the box, brought down by Addison, and that's a very rash challenge from Jay Blackie. Albany Hodgson, known to her teammates here at Cambridge simply as Albs, one of the products of the development system. But now there's a shot on the turn there, and it goes past Pamplin from a shot on the edge of the box there from Therese Addison, and just rising up over Pamplin past a dive, and Addison gets her third of the season, and Billericay now 2-0 up literally on the 23rd minute. So just over the midway point here at St Neots in the rain. Billericay leading the Lady Hughes by 2-0. Danica Dougal on 2 minutes, and then Therese Addison on 23. But here comes Jay Blackie, tripping the ball forward up towards Addison, who's into the penalty area and sends it high over that top right corner. Just couldn't keep that shot down. And this looking already a little bit on the ominous side for Kevin Hoover's side this afternoon. Now Blanche out on the right hand side of the penalty area. Cambridge have not seen too much action in the opponent's penalty area this afternoon, and just been forced on the back foot just inside their own half now, Cambridge, and it's Talian Burke's pass telegraphed and picked up by Jones, and now a sweeping move on the left-hand side. Vale plays in Lucy Jones. Jones moves the ball into the box, just bouncing towards Pamplin, who judges the flight of it and gets to it. Gathers it safely. Cambridge short ball forward, but again, played too close to Lumley, who's come gallivanting out of defence and just left them in a bit of trouble here. And here comes Kelly Blanchard for Cambridge, going into loads of space on the right-hand side. She's being trapped back by Dougal. The cross in, just into the box, and Lyne gets it. Can Lyne get the ball in? And the referee blows up. But from here, I can't see, obviously, what that was for. From Austin hiding in the main stand side, that didn't look obvious to me what that was for. I didn't see anything too untoward, but Tom Beaton, a bit closer to that challenge than I was, maybe saw something he wasn't, well, definitely saw something he wasn't happy with. But and again, when things aren't going your way, so Pamplin begins to run up from the left-hand side of her six-yard box, and immediately a kick picked up by Billericay. And that's interesting, the foul on Vicky Lyons. Well, I thought that was a foul being given, but Alex Sessions flags up, but well, the flag was given, that was saying for offside. If that was for offside, you can't be offside in your own half. And if that was for a foul, though, it wasn't there. So, curious decisions. And this is led in Billericay, rushing with the ball, but the Killane steer it into the side netting. And just compounding and adding to the frustrations for Cambridge United this afternoon. I don't know. Look, I'm wearing a T-shirt. I don't know what your problem is. But Cambridge have his corner defend. It's driven low in, not fully cleared. And Blackie with a shot. And I think Liz Pamplin knew too much about that. Sort of shot into the key and sort of just hits her gloves and just leans over. Lancaster whips this in again. This time delivered a bit better and not fully cleared. And scrambling around the area, and Cambridge leading a charmed life there. And all it needed was the visitors on a counter-attack again with Morgan. Cross into the box, picking up Russian, who evades a challenge and brings out a good save from Pamplin, but Russian with a follow-up. Can't get the shot in, and Albany Hodgson, Albs with the clearance, but a good reflex stop there by the feet of Pamplin. On the edge of the area, Katie White, Gemma Croucher, Kellyanne Burt's there as well. It's a low ball in. Now the ball just sort of getting trapped under Kellyanne Burt's feet, and Dougal brings it forward now into the centre to Addison. Cambridge still with players forward, looking to launch a little counter of their own. They've got to be careful here because they're out of shape, and here comes Russian on the left wing now for Billericay. It's a free kick to Cambridge United, which Pamplin will take to the left side of the penalty area. Chips a ball up. Up towards Croucher. Crisp in midfield now for Cambridge United. Steering the ball straight towards Lyons. Little touch now for Croucher on the halfway line. Sending the ball forward. Jenkins powering through the middle. Mullet's come out of her area and could be in trouble here. And losing the ball in the middle. And Blanchard gets it. Cambridge in possession. Croucher very nearly gets it now. Jenkins does for Cambridge United. And that was a moment that could have gone horribly wrong for Amy Mullet. In the meantime, we can confirm that Sophie Bell has been withdrawn for Billericay, been replaced by Freya Fuller. Now Cambridge spotting a bit of opportunity here. With a shot in the box there, and just across the front of a lunging that Vicky Lyons, who's appealing. I think she was caught as she went in there, and she's face down in the turf, slow to get up, and appeal for penalty not given by the referee. Shot from range, by Charlotte Crisp, who's got previous to doing that this season. And so Kelly Blanchard, I think, was struggling as well in that box. And again, Vicky Lyons does seem to be struggling. A shot on the edge of the area, though, ball end of end action with Lindsay Morgan. In fact, I think the first change has been made. I think that third sub was made when we didn't see it, because I say Maya Turner is on, and that's unfortunately the danger of doing these games in this level at step four. Sub boards aren't used. So now break on for Cambridge United. The ball into the middle there. Gemma Moore playing in Jenkins now. Jenkins right hand side. A shot, rasping shot there, rising there. And Mullet did well to get hold of that. Here comes Turner out to the right hand side for a bit of Ricky. Finding Esme Lancaster. Just checks a run. Linking up the ball now to Turner. Plays it essentially to Zoe Russian, who just can't quite get a shot off. She does eventually. And tipped over there by Pamplin. Good reflexes there, reaction from the keeper, seeing the danger, and again that shot put in with some power, anchoring that defence. As Blackie switching play out to the right hand side, ball controlled by Lancaster, quickly being tracked there by Croucher, and Crisp gets a foot in there. The ball runs loose, a shot on the edge of the area though, another good stop there from Liz Pamplin with a stinging shot there, throwing it for Billericay. On the left wing with that Hannah Smith, and the loose ball into the middle picked up by Blackie, who's got a lot of time here. Shoots some range, and again past the dive of Liz Pamplin. But I think Pamplin actually got something to that. Trying to get on the goal scoring sheet if they can, but time is rapidly running out here this afternoon. The referee's already had a glance at his watch. Tom Beaton and. The whistle, is that going to go? And that is the full-time whistle here at St Neots Town's at Premier Plus Stadium. It finished Cambridge United Women 0, Billericay Town Ladies 2. I'll leave a start that Cambridge wanted in 2 minutes, conceding a penalty. It's a sharing the joke there with Keith from Mildenhall Town, one of the Mildenhall Massive, who still comes over and supports Cambridge United Ladies, who were playing at Mildenhall Town last season. But as I said before, that's a goal on 2 minutes from the penalty spot by Danica Dougal after Zoe Russian had been upended. And then on 23 minutes, a shot on the edge of the area zipped in by Therese Anderson for her third of the season. So it's just two goals conceded this afternoon. And with very much a patched up team and very much a totally rejigged side. Only five of last. But from all of us here this afternoon at St Neots Town, it's a very, very good afternoon. And for me, Chris Walker, your commentator, enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Indeed, enjoy the rest of your weekend. Until the next time, well, for me, it will be Tuesday night. Bye-bye from now. And indeed, bye-bye for me. Ta-da.